Floyd, when you took your longest breaks, congratulations, by the way. When you took your longest breaks before, it seemed like there was a someone out there that could kind of stoke those fires to come back. When you look at the current landscape of boxing, are you convinced that there's no one out there that's going to do that for you in the next year or so?
No, I'm okay. You know, I had a game plan. I had a game plan from the beginning. You know, like I told you, if I just think, most people think right now, I have a longevity game plan. I always knew. I wanted to be outspoken. I wanted to be outspoken, be one of a kind. And at one particular time, I wanted fame. When I was young, I did. Now, you know, when I'm older and wiser, I wish I would just got the fortune, but if I wouldn't have got the family, I wouldn't be where I'm at. So everything plays out for a reason. Everything happens for a reason. You know, when I just sit back and just think about my career, all I did was just take one fight at a time. I never overlooked anyone. But what these fighters don't do is what I've done. You know, within the year, I was like 19 going to 20, or 20 is all already a millionaire. And even though I was already rich, I go to my promoter. At that particular time, it was top rank. And I walked to the office and I said, well, put my name on the board. So you just fought, put my name on the board again. He said, Floyd, we cannot afford to pay you. Because remember, I was in the 96 Olympics. So I was a high prospect and I was going about. At that particular time, I'm the highest paid one of the highest paid fighters under their banner. Of course, I think at that particular time, Oscar De La Hoya was their highest paid fighter at that time. But I was one of their highest paid fighters. Because I think my first fight, I got like 25,000. And you know, and then I was making like, you know, 80s and stuff. But crazy story, and this is for all the young fighters. I said, put my name on the board, I want to fight. They went, we can't afford to pay. I said, well, how much can you afford to pay? Just to let everybody know it's not always about the money. Because I was already rich. He said, 7,500. I said, give it to me. Sometimes he said, we can't. I said, what can you give? He said, afford to pay you 9,500. Give it to me. I fought 17 fights in a year and became world champion. And I've been world champion for 18 years. And three of those guys may they rest in peace, but they all played a major key in my career. CHICANITO HERNANDEZ gave me my shot. May he rest in peace. Corrales, you know, and Miss Corrales, his wife, you know, she runs the Nevada Boxing Hall of Fame. She's a great woman. And her husband, may he rest in peace, he was a great man. And we both were undefeated. And each one of those fights took me to another level. ARTURO GATTI, may he rest in peace. That was my first pay-per-view fight. So those days I don't remember. And if I keep fighting, I might have a sharp mind. So you know I gotta get up out of there.